Adrenal distress. It's important to understand the role of the adrenal glands to produce either cortisol, adrenaline, or DHEA. Cortisol is one of the most important hormones in the human body, and yet, whenever you hear someone talk about it, it's usually discussed in a negative light. Believe me, I've heard it all, and I'm telling you that Mr. Cortisol has gotten a bad rap. He really isn't a bad guy once you get to know him. You know, without the functions of cortisol, you would die in hours. It's that vital for your body. In my opinion, all the misinformation that's been spread about cortisol has probably kept a lot of people suffering from low cortisol when they could have been feeling healthy and energized. Okay, so now that I've gotten your attention, let's talk some more about cortisol. Where does it come from? Cortisol is produced every hour by the adrenal glands. For what reason? Well, traditionally, the answer you would get has been that the body needs cortisol to fight stress, so cortisol is a stress hormone. That's somewhat true, but it's not really the whole story. Cortisol is indeed released in stressful situations. This is how it got the title stress hormone, but the belief has been proven wrong, or at least partially wrong, many times over since those original studies were done. Dr. Susie Shooter explains in her book, Trauma Drama Effect, that lack of cortisol can cause people to act over dramatic or lose their ability to even deal with minor stress. What happens in these people unconsciously forces them to get very emotionally worked up even over minor concerns in order to restore the balance of cortisol so that they feel better. This same tendency also can fuel things like alcohol or drug addictions. It's the chicken and the egg scenario. But the bottom line is, it's better to have the right amount of cortisol and not need it than to need it and not have it. Which brings us to the adrenal fatigue. If cortisol is not present in levels adequate to drive free fatty acids into the cells, amino acids, or glucose, then what happens next? You feel hungry, even after you've just eaten sufficient food. That can cause you to overeat and become obese. Next, the adrenals start using adrenaline to do the job of cortisol, which cannot be maintained very long. The adrenals can't keep up with the demand while maintaining their own normal function, and that's when people get adrenal fatigue. So the point here is that adrenal distress or adrenal fatigue, these things can be relieved if we go to the source of the problem and support the adrenals. And you don't have to take my word for it. The foremost authorities on cortisol in the world is inclusive of Dr. Terry Hertog, who told me personally that about half of all his patients need to be on cortisol supplementation, adrenal support, and you can read the book Safe Uses of Cortisol by William McKinley Jeffries. So just know that cortisol is not your enemy. Get tested and find out if supplementation is appropriate for you. Thanks for watching. Nick Delgado. Bye for now.